You grew up on Paul Band. How big is your reserve?
8 by 8, I believe. Not a very big reserve.
Uh-huh.
There's a lake out there. You know. there's a lake out there called Wabaman.
Uh-huh.
And we grew up around the lake area because that's where all the food that we need was fish, duck eggs, ducks, muskrats, beaver, everything that we need to eat.
Making me hungry.
Yeah, me too. cooking muskrat tails on the stove. We grew up in something like this. How we're sitting right now, how this teepee is behind me. We grew up eating nothing but traditional food.
Mm-hmm.
We traveled for about 2-3 days before we can get to our hunting area where the men were supposed to hunt. And then we'd stay there, and ladies would dry the meat and to preserve it, like, you know, keep it for the winter. Dry berries, Saskatoons, mostly Saskatoons, crushed choke cherries, played in a creek, and our mother would be out gone snaring rabbits or trying to shoot a chicken or get us something to eat, and us kids would... We were taught to be responsible at a really young age.
Mm-hmm.
5-6 year old, you were already told a lot of things, a lot of the life that you're going to live for the rest of your life. They taught us responsibility, hauling wood, baking bannock, and it was only a big one-room cabin and an upstairs, but we all lived downstairs, especially in the winter. It's too cold. Wooden fire stove, no propane, no nothing. I started school when I was 9 year old.
Was it like a residential school or anything like that?
No. No? We had to walk to school every day.
Uh-huh.
Walk to school or ride horses. When it's like this, we'd ride horses in a fall time like this. In the winter, we had to walk.
Uh-huh. So did you guys ever come to the city much?
No, we didn't know what the city was then.
Even though it was right there, Edmonton?
Yeah, we didn't know. We didn't know the city at all. We were just little country kids. We didn't know anything outside of our reservation.
Mm-hmm.
The only thing we knew was a little village called, it's still there, it's the hamlet of Duffield, and there's a hall called Duffield Hall up there, and we must have been about 12, 13 year old. A guy used to come and show movies there, mostly Western movies. And oh, I just loved that. I used to picture myself in those movies when I watched it.
So now you're in the movies?
Now, when I was growing up, I said, I'm going to be a movie star. I'm going to be a nurse. I had several goals in my mind. I'm going to be a movie star. I'm going to be a nurse. Or I'm going to be, mostly it was movies in my head. But I never ever thought I'd ever get there, never. And
how did that happen?
Well, first of all, how that happened was my son, the younger one, the one that shot a moose. I don't know when he's ever gonna get here, but he started us off. One day he got an agent in Edmonton. That was after we moved to Edmonton. So one day, he was really excited. He comes home and said, you know what? I'm going to go and make a movie someplace. I'm going to go make a movie with Graham Greene. And that was a long time ago. That, you know, like, when I started, it was 94, when I started to do that. Before that, he was doing it.
You started acting in 1994?
I started acting in 1994. So uh-huh. I said, oh, what did you do to get that? Oh, I go see my agent and he'll set you up for something. You have to take a course and everything. So I went to see this agent, and he did put me through a course I had to take for acting. Taught me that what I had to do and what I didn't have to. You know, he taught us how to block out that fourth wall, that's the crowd, that's one of the things he taught us. You can't concentrate on the crowd when you're doing something, otherwise you're gonna get distracted. My agent made me audition for certain movies, which I got into. That's what got me into doing Dream Keepers. And, you know, so, Don't Call Me Tonto, and other movies that I can't remember. I haven't even seen them myself, but I did a lot, and a lot of commercials.
Mm-hmm.
And then I got into Ginger Snap, which is the horror movie. And I got into Hank Williams' First Nation with late Gordon Tootoosis. And that was supposed to be a series, but he, unfortunately, we couldn't continue because he wasn't here any longer. The hospitality that I get when I go to movies, comparing to all the cold and suffering and hunger sometimes when I was young, a little girl, it made a great big difference.
Mm-hmm.
I did a movie in Italy that was flying over the ocean. Me and my son, the movie star himself, and a lot of other young people from Siksika, Blackfoot. And we went to do a movie out there called My West. We flew over the ocean, and I was so scared that every time the plane farted a little bit, I'd grab my son and, oh, what's gonna happen to us? And, you know, and when you look out the window, it's just straight black. It was, but you know what? Once you get on that plane and you're way up there, there's no turning back. I just got to tell myself, okay, oh well, whatever happens, happens, you know. You get used to it like that.
Mm-hmm.
But it was so exciting. I got to meet a lot of people, a lot of Mayans, a lot of people like me, you know, different people. And becoming an actress and getting all that things that I'd never experienced before made me happy.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I was just happy to do something that I always wanted to do.
What would you say to a small child who has the same dreams? How do they accomplish that?
Determination. Always think of whatever your dream was, you have to be determined to go out and get it.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't, like I always tell my kids, when if one of you ever want to send your kids to acting, you have to teach them not to be shy. You have to teach them that they got to learn to face the crowd. But my dream came true. And my nursing dream also came true. I took the nursing training in, well, I think it was about 10 years ago. But I did get my certificate, but I never followed it up. I just was more interested in acting. It's been a beautiful life for me. Even through years back to today, it's been a beautiful life for me. Because I've accomplished everything I always wanted to do.